Nowadays, people call Porto Velho like the problem city. But what I have to say is, for problems, we have solutions. And I affirm that there is a solution for Porto Velho. And I will be who is going to find and apply it. My name is Melissa Venturelli, and I'm here happy to announce to Porto Velho that I will be running for mayor. As well, I would like to ask for your help in my undertaking. In Porto Velho, we live with problems that are not from today. Our problems that our parents and our grandparents have been living for a long time. But now is the time to change that. So our children and our grandchildren will not live with the same problems. Our issues reflect in economy, increasing hunger in homes, reflect in the view of our city, making people don't believe in the capacity of Porto Velho. And last but not least, this is the security, the constant fear of our citizens. But what I have to say is, we cannot accept that. As I said before, for problems, we have solutions. And now, I will show the solutions that I plan to solve the problems that we have been living for a long time. In urban area, one of the biggest problems is unemployment. This logistic is one point that the next mayor must take in consideration. Because besides the basic areas like health and education, we still need to solve unemployment in the current market. The key word is specialization. Research indicates that Rondônia is one of the most regions with lower flow of specialized people for specific occupations. Despite, this is not caused of lack of resource, but because inefficient and inadequate specialization course. Another problem faced by the companies is that after the professional reads the qualification, he or she starts to require best fees and work conditions, relinquishing the company that invests in their qualification. The alternative to that would be the city itself to qualify the labor. In fact, I will do this. Open more public specialization course with skilled professionals to teach and with affordable price for the population, which sometimes is the main obstacle to people who have disposition but without investment opportunities. As a result, we can solve one of the biggest problems present in the current market, unemployment. And that will be a step for a better economics, and we will make the labor market occupied by competent and specialized people. Porto Velho is a very developed city, currently by neighborhood towns and other municipalities. One of the greatest factors contributing for this vision is the lack of cleanliness and care in the public spaces, which also causes the potential of our city to not be noticed. We as citizens must help together to resolve this problem and show that our city has great proposals and opportunities. According to research, there is still no specific policy for collecting this material. Our residues remain directly discarded in the landfill. For now, the garbage is being deposited with no form of treatment. Seeing that, the necessity to deploy a solid waste treatment and reuse program in the municipality is evident. This is one of my main proposals for Porto Velho. Regardless of its source, each residue type will have its classification and the appropriate way of reuse. Another advantage is that the population will have the option to work voluntarily to contribute to the cleanup of our city. With the effort of all, we can make Porto Velho, our homeland, have the opportunity to show how respected and cared by its citizens our city it is. And that begins in each of us the willingness to make our city a better place to live with our cooperation. The lack of security has had alarming increases in Porto Velho. Many lives lost or deleted by lack of protection. This has increased the fear of the population on the streets and avenues. Fear is constant. According to the military policy, there are at least 1,600 cops acting on the streets of Porto Velho. But the number is still considered insufficient. Because of the great demand of the Brazilian prison overpopulation, the government's solution is to invest heavily in the construction of new prisons to fund the expenditure on food and safety. And that's definitely one of my Porto Velho proposals when it comes for security. It will reduce expenditure on the process of building new prisons, saves the labor of the prisoners in the construction. Keeping a prisoner in the prison system, it costs expense for governments, and population does not agree with that account in the citizens' pocket. As you observe, Porto Velho has enormous potential, totally unexplored and poorly administered. Successive managements that were doing things without any planning, with teams without qualification, and political issues hindered the development of the city that could be the jewel of the northern region of the country. With the help of all, we will be able to make Porto Velho, our city, be a safe, a clean, and a city of opportunities. We can, and we will make Porto Velho be a better city. I believe that just like me, you may be tired of insults to our city. We don't have to endure this. I will show that here is a valued city. As I said, I will find a solution to our problems. I will go a new way. With my help, Porto Velho will be a city of change, a city of projects, a city of evolution. And so, everyone will see the true identity of Porto Velho. But for that to happen, I need the help of all of you. As I said, me and you cannot do this alone. We need support, and that's why I need the trust of you all. So, with that, we can have a new Porto Velho. Thank you for your attention and the opportunity to present my tenders to our city. I am Melissa Venturelli, and I'm running not just for mayor, but also for a person who will find a solution to our dream, Porto Velho.